Let's see the Doppler effect of light. This is the Doppler effect of sound. Then what is the formula for the light? Let's guess the formula. We use the speed of light c instead of speed of sound, and it is very tempting to insert the velocities of detector and source of light. But here we should use the relative velocity of the detector with respect to the source, instead of just the velocity of detector and the velocity of source. Why is that so? For sound, the velocities of sound, detector, and the source are all measured with respect to the medium. But for light, only relative velocity is meaningful because there is no medium. So the relative velocity is used, and there is a square root due to the special relativistic effect. This is the Doppler effect of light. When the detector and the source are getting closer, the detected frequency is getting higher and the detected wavelength gets shorter. This is called blue shift. When the detector and the source are getting further, the detected frequency is getting lower and the detected wavelength gets longer. This is called red shift. We can approximate the formula when the relative velocity is much smaller than the speed of light. When the detector and the source are getting closer, the detected frequency can be approximated like this. And the detected wavelength is approximated like this.